everyone, my name is Vale. I would like to share some recommendations for you to take your senses on a tour. I grew up in Mexico and I studied biology in my hometown, Querétaro. It's all desert. There is nothing like the Pacific Northwest there. So it was a challenge, definitely, to come to a new place and learn about it. There are six tips, six recommendations that I would like to share with you so you can go explore and be successful. The first one is do a research before going to this place you want to explore. Take a look at maps and look for a list of species that you can find. Find out what's the climate patterns on that specific area. And geography, cultural biodiversity. Take a moment also to find out about indigenous land. Who was the people who was here before us? And learn about their languages, their traditions. Take a moment to honor indigenous science because they are the people who have been here since immemorial times, and they have thousands of years of careful observations about this ecosystem. They have been doing experiments, and that body of knowledge is our major source of information to understand how we fit into this ecosystem or the ecosystem you are about to explore. Second, connect with the community. One of my favorite topics to start a conversation with a local people is to talk about the weather. There's a lot of locals who are happy to share with you all their knowledge about this environment that you are about to explore and share it with you. So I would recommend to be careful at doing those connections because you want to be respectful. You want to be humble, want to be thankful for those who were open to share that knowledge with you. When I arrived to Washington, I got really surprised by all this web of hikes that we have available here, but definitely this doesn't happen in a lot of places. So if you are gonna go to a place that doesn't have a very specific path, a hike, then there is a couple of things you need to do. And first of all is connect with the locals. Share your purpose of being an explorer in this new environment and ask for a guide. Ask for permission too. Maybe exploring in their lands is not allowed. Where I grew up, it was very common that we will have to make a stop before starting our hiking. And that stop was on a store in the corner where we will get water and food, and definitely was the best spot to connect with the community and share why we were there, because for them we were strangers. So yeah, make that connection. Third recommendation is go volunteer. Connect with the experts of the topics you are interested on. There is a lot of groups and organizations who are happy to take your help and share with you all their knowledge. When I came to Washington, I connected with the Basho Nature Center, and that's how I met Jeff Adams. And I start volunteer for him and his research about finding green crabs in the shores of Bashan. I also went and took beach walks with Maria Melter and lots of nature lovers. And I also volunteer for doing forage fish monitoring on the beaches of Bashan. So definitely go volunteer. It's a great opportunity for you to connect with the experts and explore the environment. Recommendation number 4, access to books. There is a lot of sources from what you can learn a lot about the environment that you are about to explore. Find identification guides. If there is not any books about the environment you are about to explore, go and do a little research about what science groups are on that area doing research. I, for example, took a look at the Bachelor Nature Center website, found a lot of information about list of species and how to interact with the wildlife, because definitely I wasn't ready and I didn't know how to encounter a blackbird or a cougar in doing a hike. You can also go to the museums, and I will definitely recommend to join to Facebook groups of nature lovers, and that's how you also can connect with locals. One of my most powerful tools to recognize species is iNaturalist, so I would definitely recommend to download this app. Recommendation number 5 is dress properly to go explore outdoors. Check the weather before going out and be safe. Recommendation number 6, just go out and explore. Use all your senses to find natural patterns in comparison with the ones that you have seen in other types of ecosystems. Use all the knowledge you gather during this research and what people share with you. So this is gonna be really helpful for you to go explore and learn more about the ecosystems. Maybe you have to bring identification guides, and that's okay. Maybe you are not gonna know maybe anything about this new environment, and that's okay, because when you go out with all your senses, you will learn and you will question and wonder how this could happen. Why is it like that? I wonder. It reminds me of. Make that connections with the environments you have explored previously. In this exploration, it's fun to share this experience with friends, with local people. So invite your friends to go out and explore, take notes, share what you learn, and most important, be always respectful with nature. Leave it as you found it. I hope these recommendations help you when you go out and explore other areas that you don't know a lot about it, to take your senses on a tour. I hope you have fun and find a lot of interesting things in your new seed spot. Make observations and take notes, and don't forget your data sheet. If you have any questions or wanna share anything with me, please send me an email. I would love to hear from you. Have fun. Bye.